Boom!
There it is. Oh. There's the live. Oh my God, we have Seth Godin with us.
What an honor. Seth, how are you?
It's good to see you, man. And I've just been sponging up everything you've been putting down. Thank you. This is one of the great moments of web history right here on the screen. And here we are back again. So you just answered my last question, but the next one I have for you is this. You are really clearly continually living on the frontier and dancing with the future. But you've been at this ever since the wine store in New Jersey. And the question I'm going to ask on behalf of web creators is, what's the one thing, not the next big thing, but the old and still reigning big thing that they don't get yet? Just let us know.
That's a great question. Thank you, Seth. First of all, it's just really good to see you. I hope you're well.
We need to go for a walk soon.
Yeah, I'll text you after this. Thank you so much. It's so nice to see you. That the mix of math and intuition is a very important relationship. I think the thing that is allowed, you know, you don't know what that feels like. And I hope I've made it clear every time we've interacted, my incredible admiration for you. For you to say continue, it means the world to me because I admire you. And I think what the old thing, which is the new thing, it's always the same game, which is there's a level of intuition. There's so much pattern recognition I had. Even by the time I got into liquor store, you know, you say since the wine store, so much of my lemonade, sports card, shoveling snow, as I get older, a little more wiser, you start realizing, oh wow, even that was the pattern recognition that helped me, you know, with the wine stuff so quickly, which then I built on. It's having the humility and the conviction in balance, the gray and the black and white, the math. Because if it was one or the other, it just, you know, that's where we see failure. You see too many people using data as a look back, which is why they don't see the next thing, which is why enormous companies fail, right? And then you have other people that are a little bit too off the reservation on, it's all like, they completely don't have, you know, they have these incredible intuitive feelings, but they're not willing to look at truth in their face and take a back step. And so, especially for these web creators, you know, I was very taken aback by, I met so many smart friends who had web shops who just genuinely dismissed this, Seth. You know, these were my first rodeos. So I hadn't been around smart people who were blindly pushing against something that was so obvious because they either were tired and didn't want to, I have a lot of empathy for it. They were tired and didn't want to learn a new craft. They were making too much money and they didn't want the thing to change. You know, I always tell people, I don't want TikTok to happen. I've got Instagram figured out. I don't want Instagram to happen. I had Twitter figured out. Like, you know, I don't have this great want for these new things to happen. They become work every time. But I know that there's no shot for me to be successful in what I do without it. So I would say the relationship between intuition and math and not over-indexing one or the other, and if it doesn't come natural, one or the other, surrounding yourself with teammates, that is just a tried and true old thing.